I wanted to share with you two fun features in Microsoft Teams. One is sharing your Microsoft form with those who collaborate with you in Microsoft Teams in that team. The benefit of doing this is that it ensures your form can be seen, modified, edited, and those results can be seen by that entire team in Microsoft Teams so that you can share and collaborate with that. Forms that you have under your personal account can end if you were to transfer or move to a different area. So in order to ensure access at all times, a best practice is to make sure those forms are shared with the team. I'm already logged in to Forms Online, so I was gonna highlight just a few of these. You can see the when it's just for me or when I'm sharing that form with the team. In order to make that change, you would scroll down, select All My Forms, and then you would hover over whatever form it is you're wanting to edit. Select those three dots, and then you can select Move to a Group. That's going to pull up all of the teams on Microsoft Teams that you're a part of. Scroll down till you find that team that you're wanting to share the form with. Select it and press Move. And then when you go back to your main forms dashboard, you'll see that that form is now available to the entire team to have access to. So it won't be lost if you transition out of a job or have new team members. They'll automatically have access to it with your team. Feature number two I wanted to share. Going back to the All My Forms icon at the bottom, there is now a feature where you can import existing forms from a PDF or a Word file. To do that, you select that quick import, you'll select the form. I've created or grabbed just a general form online. It's a PDF. Select form, and it takes just a moment or two to convert that into Microsoft Forms. I will say that this process is beneficial, but not perfect. It's great if you have a form with a question and then an answer. If you have a form that's complex, that offers a lot of charts or sentiment questions, you're not going to find that it transitions over as easily as it does those blank spaces. Let's take a look and start the quick review. You can see that it pulled over that header information, which can be easily modified or deleted. When you scroll further, you'll see that the titles, the question and answer boxes are automatically generated for you from your PDF. Now, when we scroll down, you'll notice that those sentiment questions don't transition as easily, but they are identified as an issue with that conversion. You can go in and edit them. Those are your two fun facts about forms. I hope it helps.